Hello, people of BS4. This is for me. We're going to continue from where we ended the last time. But before we start everything, please don't forget your hand sanitizer. Make sure you rub a little in your palm. And also wear your nose mask when you are going out. Okay? We are still on the modeling. We're going to learn about tools needed. Tools that we'll be using. Tool number one is knife. It's what? Knife or cutter. You are aware of it. Instead of knife, I normally use cutter. Tools number two is a flat stick. A flat stick. We use this for modeling. You make sure you rub it this way to make sure the fabric is very smooth or flat. Or we can even use the scraper. This place is metal, while this place is either plastic or wood. Okay. We can also, the most important thing that you're supposed to have is the human hands. Your hands, they are very, very important. In terms of creative arts, it's very, very important. So whenever you are about to write tools for any other thing, make sure you include what your hands. It's very, very important for you to use. We are learning about how we can create a papier-mâché or how we can bring about papier-mâché. I believe we've heard of it before, but this time now we're going to do it ourselves. Please get a bowl like us. Please get a bowl like us. Or you can even use a basket. A bucket. Make sure you fill it with what? Water. You make sure you fill it with water. We are supposed to use newspapers, but I have papers here, very nice ones, that I would like to use them. This is how we're going to do it. You are not supposed to crumple it this way and put it in the water. But you mean, if you do it this way, you can never pound it. It's very, very difficult when you're about to pound the papers. So please make sure you tear them into pieces, smaller pieces. You tear them into what? Smaller pieces. You do it this way. I've been telling you, the lazy ones find it very difficult. In the practicals, but this time I believe we've all changed. So you tear it this way to smaller pieces. Take your time. You can even give it to your younger sister or brother. They are very good in tearing. The kids are very good in tearing. So please and please. Do it this way. Tear them into pieces, so please. Tear them into pieces. Smaller pieces. Don't just tear it this way and put it in. It's not accepted. That's the main reason why I said make sure you can even give it to your younger brothers and sisters. And if you don't tear plenty of it, you wouldn't get the actual size that you need for your modeling. That's the main reason I'm taking my time in tearing. I don't want to do any lazy work. Because in the house, I wouldn't be around to supervise how you have your papier mache. Okay? So while doing this way, I'm going to leave it. Today is Friday. I'm going to leave it till Friday, 3 days. So it's going to be either Monday or Tuesday. Say it like this. Be very fast in tearing. Give them to your younger sisters and brothers. They will do it for you. For the kids, they are very good in tearing. Give it to them. So you can tear as plenty as you need. Because we are having a lesson, I've decided to just leave it this way. But I'll continue after the lesson so that I can also prepare my own papier mache. I have it like this. Make sure you soak the paper very well. Soak it. Leave it for either 3 or 4 days. You leave it like this. After the 3 or 4 days, you get your mortar and your pestle. Then you pound it. Not the one that will be using for fufu, but the one that we normally use for the palm nuts. Pound it very neat and nice too. Into smaller pieces. If you're able to pound it and pound it well, for that one, you please ask mommy or your elder sister to assist you in it. But it's not that easy. You may think because it's like this, it's easy for you to pound. No. Even after the 3 days, it's very difficult. So you leave it to maybe 3 or 4 days, then you pound it. When you are done, go for the cassava starch. We have the already made one. When it gets to the provision stores, they have the already made one. One is 50 pesos or so. When you are done with the pounding, you mix it with the starch. Or you can even use white glue. Because mostly in the school, we use white glue. Ask mommy to buy white glue from any of the shops. Those that sell the plywood, the nails and other stuffs, they have it. It costs about 10 cedis. It's either you go for that one or you go for the starch. The starch is there 50 pesos. So when you buy about maybe 3 cedis, you get about 6. You can use it in your modeling. Please, we will do the practicals here. I'm going to do it with you. So we've soaked it right now. On Monday, you pound it very neat. But always on Tuesday, we will continue from where we got to. So that at least we will all do it together. Before we end, make sure you get a bowl like this. A bowl like this. Or a bowl like that. I don't need it, the 5-5, the silver ones. We need the plastic bowls like this for the work. So please and please, get your own bowl, okay? We're going to end over here. We started with the tools for modeling. I said knife is one. In place of the knife, you can use your cutter. Two is what? Any flat stick. Don't forget, this place is very, very flat, okay? And the human hand, which I said is very, very important in creative arts. The scraper is also over there. We also use that one to make the item very smooth as the knife, we pass it over the object that we want to mold. And I remember I started with how we can prepare our own papier mache. I remember I said, we tear the papers into pieces. Fill your container, your bowl, your bucket with water. Tear the papers into pieces, then you soak it for 3 to 4 days. When after the 3 to 4 days, you get your mortar and your pestle, then you pound it in. It's very, very, it's going to be like gari. It's going to have the texture is like gari. We will be using it for the modeling. Then also get your starch, please. Get your starch. We are not in the school, which I will by all means promise you the school is going to provide. So tell mommy to buy the starch, the already made starch for you. That one, you just add water to it, then you stir it. Cold water or warm water, then you stir it like that, so that at least we can use for our work. Thank you very much for being with me. Stay at home, stay blessed. And also save your life. Thank you very much.